with it. So baby, can't you see that you were meant for me?
This is tragic, but it need not be the case. This doesn't have to be the end. It could be the beginning of a beautiful relationship, the relationship of your dreams, if you read The Facts of Life and Love for Teenagers. You can improve your own dateability by following a few simple rules to help you overcome those uncertain moments. It can help if you develop a method of dating. For example, John calls for Mary at her home at the appropriate time. Mary is ready for John and answers the door herself, greeting him pleasantly. Mary introduces John to her parents and tells them where they are going. Smiling at John, Mary suggests they leave. John opens the door for Mary while accepts the courtesy with a gracious smile. Mary and John go on the date and have a good time. After the date is over, Mary is very careful not to linger by the front door, lest John get any ideas. There is one area of courtesy that must be strictly observed upon your entry into the dating jungle. It's important to note that at all times you must try to make yourself appear attractive. Even though you will never win a beauty contest, it is essential that you appear well-groomed. That sweet, clean, well-scrubbed look has won over many a reluctant date. As a boy gets into his teens, he begins to experience new reactions to certain special girls. He may suddenly discover a girl who sets his mind on fire and makes his palms sweat. During this phase, boys often cluster in groups and whistle at girls who pass by. The whistle is the boy's way of recognizing the girl as female. The girl with poise, who accepts the whistle, often helps the boys to feel that she's approachable. Another potential danger area of the modern date is conversation. What do you talk about? Taking the weather as a simple illustration, let's check out a sample conversation.
Wonderful night, isn't it?
Grand! Have you ever seen such a moon?
It's what they call a hunter's moon, isn't it?
A hunter's moon? That sounds interesting. Do you hunt?
There you are, from the weather to his pet hobby in four simple steps.
Important words. Whoa, whoa, that's all.
Let us now discuss dating hazards. Someday, you may be the victim of a line. You know, when we're younger, we believe all the sweet things we're told. But someday, we come to the abrupt realization that we can't always believe the things other people say. We often face the disillusionment that comes with believing a line and learn to respond with equally shallow sentiments. Lines to be wary of include such popular favorites as,
"Yes, I'll always love you."
And,
"Of course I'll respect you."
During the date, you may find that you've been taken to a questionable location. At this point, it's a wise idea to stop and ask yourself a few simple questions. What do I want out of life? Would going to this particular spot help me along the road to my future? If the answer is no, don't go. The boy who thinks of himself as a creature of appetites may seek momentary satisfaction of his every diseased whim. He eats girls' reputations for breakfast. He's the boy who always wants to go too far. A girl with faith in her future will refuse to go to questionable spots.
Never look for trouble.
This brings us to our next topic. You'll probably find it useful to learn how to say no on your dates. Let's look at an example. John and Mary were very fond of each other. John found it necessary to talk things over with Mary and said something like this.
You know, I love you very much, but you sit on my lap like this, my feelings are more than I can cope with, so, let's just slide on over there and go get ourselves a hamburger, huh?
Before I go, a warning to girls. Beware. Some grown boys collect kisses and caresses from girls in much the same way that they collected hockey cards as kids. It's a jungle out there. I hope I've helped. And remember, it's never too late to learn the facts of life and love.
So baby, can't you see that you were meant for me? I want your loving, yes, sirree. I